Welcome to A.S.A.T Rocketry, a poster presentation video. Aristotle Space Aeronautics team is the first and largest aerospace student team in Greece from Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. ASAT was established by a group of undergraduate mechanical engineering students from our university with the support of the Laboratory of Fluids Dynamic and Turbomachinery. The rocket project is first of its kind in Greece and it was established in October 2016. Our primary goal is to develop the experimental rocketry field in the Greek scientific community. This desire stimulates creating a network of individuals, groups and partners around ASAT Rocketry. Right now, the rocketry team mainly consists of mechanical engineering students, but also with students from other departments like engineering and physics. Project Selene is the third high-power rocket of ASAT Rocketry and is an improved model of the previous team rockets. Selene is selected to compete to the Spaceport America Cup 2021 at the 10,000 feet COTS motor category. It has a total length of 2.4 meters, weighing 19.4 kilograms, and it's powered by a CTI Pro75 COTS solid rocket motor. Its mission is to deliver a deployable payload to the target apogee, where its deployment occurs by activating a CO2 ejection mechanism. Selene has a fully functional and deployable payload that will tally up the radon's concentration in the atmosphere. It was decided that telemetry should be included in the payload's and flight computer's function. Let's move on to each subsystem.
The aerodynamic subsystem is responsible for the design and analysis of the aerodynamic parts of the rocket, ensuring stability and overall performance. Since the mission and the requirements for the project had been set, the design process was initiated. The process was divided into three stages: conceptual, preliminary, and detailed design. Open Rocket was the preferred tool for the conceptual design for its flexibility and ease of use. During the preliminary design, the subsystem developed intermediate tools between Open Rocket and CFD simulations to enhance their work. An algorithm that exports the optimum dimensions of the fins amongst a vast number of combinations, as well as several scripts for data optimization, were created in MATLAB. CFD analysis also played a huge role in the design process. 2D and 3D CFD simulations were conducted while multiple trade-off studies took place. The pre-processing required for the CFD simulations was carried out in great detail to establish the validity of the results. During the detailed design, the rocket's assembly was analyzed for various velocities and angles of attack using CFD. In total, the CFD simulations performed during the entire design process reached up to 281, accumulating to over 2,000 CPU hours. The results of those simulations led to the selection of a Hack Series nose cone and flat fins with modified leading and trailing edges. Besides these parts, the fin module and the launch buttons were redesigned for better aerodynamic behavior. Since the design process was completed, wind tunnel testing was performed to validate the results and obtain realistic measurements. Two different models were subjected to wind tunnel testing. The first one features a 3D printed version of the nose cone, a scaled down version of the airframe, and one of Selene's fins, while the second was a 3D printed scaled down version of the whole rocket. During the whole process, the aerodynamic subsystem was documenting their work in individual reports. When every individual design was concluded, the data was given to the propulsion and structural subsystems to carry out their analysis.
The motor we selected for Selene is the Cesaroni Pro75 M1590P motor. Its selection came up through a methodology we developed, which can be applied to the most SRM motors, both SRAD and COTS. First, we take into consideration variables such as rocket masses and dimensions, and also some aerodynamic parameters. Then, a sensitivity analysis takes place. For this purpose, a MATLAB rocket flight performance code was developed within our subsystem to help us extract the influence on the rocket's altitude by changing its mass with a simultaneous change in COTS motor. Then we compare the attributed rocket performance from each candidate motor. After these procedures, all the reload kits that met all the specifications and requirements for each hardware are omitted. This determines how different values of motor variables affect the rocket under a given set of a project's missions requirements. At the motor's front edge, the forward closure is attached to the motor bulkhead through which the thrust is transferred to the rocket. Also, the motor is aligned inside the rocket lower tube with two 3D printed center rings glued at the phenolic tube, which is our motor mount.
Finally, the motor's back edge is immobilized with a retaining ring, which is screwed on the rocket airframe.
Propulsion's final contribution to the rocket is installing the igniter during launch procedures, always wearing the appropriate PPE. Once the rocket is vertical of the pump, the avionics subsystem gets equipped with the appropriate PPE and arms the flight computers. Then, propulsion member carefully inserts the igniter in the motor and ensures that it is properly placed. Then, the igniter is connected to the one end of the ignition cables. The igniter is connected to the ignition box. The team arms the three box and awaits for the right command from the ground station to initiate flight. When all personnel are at least 50 feet away from the launch vehicle. Finally, the propulsion has arranged the appropriate laboratory facilities in the university to store the propellants in a recycling room under argon between 12 to 15 centigrades.
The avionics sub-team is responsible for designing, manufacturing and testing all the electronic systems of the rocket. Selene consists of three different avionics projects. So, starting with the ground station, it is handled by the user and is totally independent and easy to transport. The hardware includes a Raspberry Pi 4, which is the brain of the ground station, the Groundmaster PCB, designed by us and responsible for the telecommunications of the ground station, an LNA connected with an SRAD helical antenna, responsible for receiving data, a monopole antenna used for transmitting data, and some peripherals such as a screen, a keyboard, a mouse, and a power bank. As for the software part of the ground station, we developed a GUI that receives live data from the rocket and displays them in various graphs. The ribbox is placed near and connected with wires to the rocket and remotely handled by the ground station. It is controlled by a PCB that we designed and named Ignition Master. Ribbox is responsible for the safe activation of the igniters through an ignition circuit consisting of three safety interlocks. Third step is to turn the key switch to activate the system. Second step is arming the ribbox. Third step, we step away and send the launch command. Then the countdown begins and the flight starts. Inside the rocket is the avionics bay that contains our SRAD flight computer and a COTS flight computer for redundancy and safety reasons, along with some batteries and arming switches. Our SRAD Flight Master Flight Computer is a PCB responsible for data logging, telemetry, and triggering the recovery mechanisms. It consists of an STM32 microcontroller that controls everything, barometer and accelerometer sensors to gather flight data, a GPS module and a GPS patch antenna to track the location of the rocket, plus an SD memories to save all the data, transceiver and a monopole antenna to transmit data back to the ground station.
The recovery subsystem is responsible for the design, manufacture and test all of the parachutes and their corresponding ejection mechanisms in order to ensure a safe recovery of the rocket. All of the parachutes have a semi-elliptical shape and have been designed and manufactured properly to comply with the rules and requirement of the Spaceport America Cup. The drogue parachute is 35 inches in diameter, the main parachute is 118 inches in diameter, and the payload parachute has 70 inches in diameter. The deployment of the drogue parachute and the payload will happen when the rocket reaches apogee. This task will be achieved with the help of the onboard flight computers and the CO2 ejection mechanisms. When the onboard flight computers detect that the apogee has been reached, they send a signal to the CO2 ejection mechanism, and then the deployment sequence begins. This ejection mechanism consists of a pressurized cartridge that contains 25 grams of CO2, a modified tire pump, and this solenoid. When the mechanism is triggered, the solenoid will allow the carbon dioxide to fill the inside of the rocket, thus ejecting the nose cone and deploying the drop parachute and the payload. As a backup ejection method, we decided to use crimson powder. This will ensure that the rocket will continue its safe descent and the payload will carry on its mission. For the main parachute to deploy, a tender descender is employed, which will trigger when the rocket descends at 1500 feet above ground level. All the mechanisms have been tested with proper layout that resemble the flight conditions with test weights. In addition, some cooperative tests with the avionics subsystem have been already conducted that prove the effective operation of the flight computer and the mechanisms.
The payload subteam is responsible for the implementation of an experiment that is going to be conducted during the rocket's flight. Selene's payload is going to tally up the radon concentration in the atmosphere, so we design an SRAD dosimeter that will be housed on a 3-unit CubeSat. Radiation Master, the PCB that we design, houses the RadFET, a PNP MOSFET transistor sensitive to ionizing radiation. When an ionizing particle passes through its gate, it creates a current which is measured by the RadFET peripheral circuits. Due to the experiment's purpose, we need to measure the alpha particles in the atmosphere, which can't overcome the rocket tube, so a deployable payload was designed. As you can see here, the payload structure is connected with its parachute, which is designed and manufactured by a recovery subteam. The payload will be released when the rocket reaches its apogee and then will follow its independent descent. When the payload passes through certain altitudes, it will take measurements from the RadFETs that shows us the radiation dose that they detected. These measurements will be sent live to the rocket's ground station implemented by the avionics subteam using an AX-53 transceiver. Last but not least, the Radiation Master has a GPS tracker in order to aid its recovery.
The structural subsystem is responsible for the design and manufacture of the bones and muscles of the rocket. The design process includes the creation of the whole model and its structural system in a 3D CAD software, the completion of technical drawings of its individual parts, the conduction of structural static analysis of the most important components, and assembly parts. Using the finite element method, static analysis was conducted on the upper motor bucket, recovery bucket, payload bucket, on the tubes of the airframe and the fins. Moreover, depending on the type of the material, orthotropic or isotropic, the necessary failure criteria are utilized. The machining of metal components is carried out through the collaboration of professionals in metal machining, while parts that are made out of composite materials are manufactured by the structural subsystem. All metal parts, except of payload structure, are made out of aluminum alloys 6061 or 6082. The fins are made out of aluminum core and are externally covered with two layers of carbon fiber, with the orientation of 0, 90, 45 and minus 45 degrees with respect to the leading edge. The rocket fins are attached to the tube using bolts, while the tubes are connected to each other using metal parts.
The nose cone consists of three layers of fiberglass with fiber orientations of 0, 90, 45, minus 45, 0 and 90 degrees. Fiberglass was chosen due to its lower cost in comparison to carbon fiber and its capability to house the electronic systems of the avionics subteam if needed. The nose cone tip is located on top of the nose cone. The nose cone shoulder is a metal part attached with epoxy. Both the nose cone and the fins, which were designed in cooperation with the aerodynamic subsystem, were manufactured through the vacuum resin infusion method. The upper and lower tubes are made of carbon fiber with orientations of 45, minus 45, 0 and 90 degrees symmetrical. The middle one, which houses the avionics vessel, needed to be radio frequency transparent, so it is made of fiberglass. The payload structure was designed in collaboration with the payload subsystem. It is made of steel and it is housed inside a 3D printed vessel. It exits the rocket with the help of the ejection mechanism, resulting to the successful deployment of the structure. Finally, the structural subteam conducted 10 cell tests in order to verify the mechanical properties of the custom-made carbon fiber that was used on the model.
The team has also prepared the necessary risk assessment and hazard analysis, as well as the safety and launch procedures to round out the project and be fully prepared for an upcoming launch.
Subsequently, the team aims to be among the best teams of the competition. Besides that, our team A.S.A.T Rocketry aims to participate in the SDL Payload Challenge and the podium session of SAC 2021. Our team awaits to present our work, meet other teams and other people in this field, and compete in the Spaceport America 2021.